Hey, this is Greta Van Fleet.
Today, we're at Sonic Boom in Toronto.
This is
the LP Spree.
Oh! Oh, did we go? This is one we grew up on. Me and Jake used to listen to this record probably about 12 hours out of the day.
I know for a fact that this is one of his favorite albums.
Moondance.
And I know for a fact this is another one of his favorite albums.
Sgt. Pepper. Man, this is just too much.
Doors, Dylan. God bless him.
I've heard this one, and this is like crack to look at. Like, this is just great stuff.
You remember Nathaniel Radcliffe?
Vaguely.
Son of a bitch, pour me a drink song.
Oh, yeah. Look at this. This is just fantastic. They got the lap steel up there. Look at that kit. Genius stuff.
I wonder if they have like a Timothy Leary album here.
I guess my goal is to kind of find something. Whenever I walk into a record store, what have I absolutely never heard of in my entire life? What looks wacky?
And I thought if there's one thing I would ever change about this movie, it would be the soundtrack. I think The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly has got to be my favorite. This is a fantastic soundtrack right here. The Mission. So this is the same guy that scored The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. He pretty much invented that sort of spaghetti western sound.
This is another one that me and Jake really put in some hours on. House of the Rising Sun off of this one. Oh man, I've been looking for this one. The Basement Tapes. This one's going under the armpit because I've been looking for this.
The Essential Elvis Presley. That's the one, gotta have it.
It's fun, I'm walking through a lot of these and I'm seeing a lot of names that we've actually had the pleasure of hanging out with or sharing stages with. That's really cool. It's really cool.
I don't know what it was about this that kind of changed reggae for me. It was like, oh, you can, there's these different things you can hear.
Yeah, I'm fire now. It goes Stephen Stills 2, then it goes Stephen Stills 1, then it goes T for the Tillerman. I've spent over 1,000 hours listening to these. Stephen Stills 1. If you haven't heard this, you should. And what's even better is Stephen Stills 2.
Finally found the Neil Young. This is great. Changed my perception of live music. I mean, Hey Hey, My My came on and I just almost cried. It was incredible.
Well, this one is a Miri Makeba album. Something about what she did for me as a singer is transcendent, really. So I had to get this. It's unprecedented.
You can get it if you really want.
Yeah, it sinks deep down into your soul,
and it convinces everybody that they've got groove or something. Right.
I don't know. One of my favorites, and this is an incredible album by the incredible Fairport Convention.
This will be my first one, Stephen Stills. One, because specifically, Love the One You're With is on it, which is a brilliant song, right? But I would say that the only record that's better than that is the Stephen Stills 2.
I was already talking about it. I don't know about that, Samuel.
It is.
I don't think so.
It is.
The Sonic Playground.
That says it all. That says it absolutely everything about this record.
My second record is a Hendrix Blues album, which is a super important, I think, historically speaking, even.
Especially Red House.
Yeah.
That,
I mean, fantastic. Good old The Essentials, Elvis Presley. And this is the quencher right here. This is
the pinnacle.
Beyond Resistance.
I found this section that said quadraphonic records. And that's records mixed in surround sound.
Do you have a quadraphonic listening media?
Oh, well, no, I don't. And then one of the most absurd albums of all time, and that's The Basement Tapes. Is that the right side? And this is the best album of all time right here. If you haven't listened to this, then you're an idiot.
So my first is Revolver by the Beatles, and for a couple reasons, not necessarily for the impact, but I mean, like, some of the songs are crucial songs in my existence. Jealous, right? T for the Tiller Man by Cat Stevens. The reason I really fell in love with the album was because of the title track. And it's the last song in the album, and it's a minute long. It's a minute long, but it's one of the most beautiful songs in the entire existence of music. Helplessness Blues by the Fleet Foxes. It's a good one, right? Every track is brilliant in its own way. And Harvest years. By Neil Young. He's a Canadian. Yes.
Neil.
Hey!
It's Greta Van Fleet, and you're watching UMUSIC. All right, can we try that one more time?